Hi, everybody. It's Janet, and we're at Fruit of the Vine Art Studio in Cincinnati, Ohio. Thank you so much for joining me here this evening. I appreciate you being here with me. When you hop on, I'd love it if you'd just say hey and tell me where you're watching from. I always appreciate hearing where everybody's looking and watching me at. It's always fun to see how many different places that you can end up in. It's amazing. Anyway, tonight we're going to do a little winter fox. And I've already kind of got this started with a, hey, Steve, thanks for commenting for me. I appreciate that. Thank you. I've already got a little starting here. I've got an orange underpainting here. So we're going to do with this orange tone. And I've kind of got the fox drawn on there. So we're going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to tilt you down and zoom you in a little bit. Well, maybe not quite that butch. That looks good right there. I'm going to scoot it down just a little bit so it's... Well, kind of keep it right here in the middle, I guess, is where we want to be. Okay, to start with, I'm going to make a... I'm going to use some yellow. Get it out here. Use a little yellow. I'm going to use a little white. That down. There we go. That's just a little white, huh? That's about what I'm going to get out of that. That's okay. We've got more here. I need a little bit of red. I got all kinds of noises going on. I'm going to use a little gold. Little bit of everything getting out here, and I'm gonna need some orange, obviously. And then we'll move into the whites and all of that fun stuff too as we go along here. Okay, now the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix them up a light yellowish color. I don't want that to fall over, so I'm just gonna put that right like that. And let me just get some white over here first. A little bit of yellow. I'm just mixing it on the palette here. A little bit of yellow. And I want a little orange. I want to make a kind of a creamy looking color. A light color. Want it to be a little more yellow. Okay. A little bit of a lighter dream sickle kind of color, I guess you could say. Let me get a little more of this over here. I'm just going to start up here in this corner with this lighter yellowish color, and I'm just going to work it in back here. A little over the edges. And I'm going to kind of bring it a little cross down through here. Get a little bit of it back in this area. bring it up in here. And then we're going to start mixing a little orange in with this. Just a little bit of orange mixed in. A little more orange in this area here. We're going to mix a little bit more of that cream color in right here. A little bit more of the orange. Hey, hi Steve. Thanks. I'm kind of waiting to see how it's going to turn out too. Hopefully it matches what's in my head. Rarely does it ever match what's in my head, to tell you the truth. But we're going to add a little more orange back here and just blend it in with this creamy color a little bit. A little more of the orange right back in here and mix it in with this creamy color a little bit. But now I want to try to maintain this really lightened area over here. So I'm just going to kind of drag this down in there, maybe get a little bit more orange down in this area. But I'm kind of wanting to maintain this pretty yellowish light color up there in this corner. Now I'm going to add just a touch of red to my orange. A touch of red to the orange, and I'm going to start bringing a little bit of a reddish orange over in this area. Maybe not quite that red, but we'll work on that here as we go. Pull a little bit more of that cream color from off the brush that's already kind of rubbed into it. And then maybe make it a little more red. Just a little more red over on this side here. Up in between these, this is going to be tree branches over in here. So we're just going to maybe a little more red and a little more orange here. Just darken this up a little bit on this side. Make this a little redder going off into the edge here. Just a little bit of it in this area. Okay, so you can kind of see how now we've got this light to darkened area behind us. Let me get a little more of that right in here. And then get me a little more of this gold. I'm going to mix a little gold in here. Bit of the gold up in between this tree trunk and maybe get a little gold over in here. A minutes in a tree area there. Let me just kind of get some in this background here. We're just adding a little bit of gold to it. Trying to tilt it up so I can see it a little better here. Make a little more of the gold kind of shining through in spots. Just kind of streaking it in here. Just some spots of gold. Okay, I think that looks all right. Okay, I'm gonna get me out a little bit of brown. And a little bit of black. Let me looky here. I'm going to get some brown right here. And I'm just going to kind of... Do I want to do that before I do the... Yeah, I think I want to do the white before I start doing this brown. Let me just get some white out instead. I need some more white. We'll do that part first right back here, and then we'll work on them trees. Gotta think about what I'm doing, guys. Every once in a while, it kind of helps if I stop to think, hey, might that not be the harder way to do this? This might be an easier way to do this here. This might just be an easier way to do this. Okay, so I'm going to get me some white. And I'm going to mix it with some orange to where I've got a very, very light orange. I'm just gonna paint this right back in here. Get a little more of that. And let me get some more of this white here, and we're just going to make it a little whiter right out here. I don't think you really can see the orange yet, can you? That's okay. Get a little bit of orange, and we're just going to kind of just drag it right along right here just a little bit, and I'm going to blend that in right there. And then we're going to get a little bit more white, and we're just going to work it right in here. Bit of orange right there. Get me a little more white. And I'm just gonna work get right up through here. Leave a little streak of that orange going right in through there. Get me another little drop of orange. Bring it right through here. This time I'm going to wipe it off a little bit better. I'm not going to wash it though. I'm going to get some more of the white. Just kind of bring it right around here. It's going to get a little bit of the orange mixed in with it, where I'm going to leave that little line of it right there, which is perfectly fine. Get a little more white. Just a little line of that orange there. Bring that on over to here. I'm going to touch into that orange again and make a line going right here. Now this seems a little odd, but that's okay. It's going to look all right in the end. You'll see. You'll kind of understand what I'm doing here. Maybe you won't. Maybe it'll look all funky and I'll have to figure out something to do to kind of mix that up and make it look a little better. Let me see. So now all of this white, I want to have just the tiniest little tint of orange in it here, but I also want it to be still pretty white. Drag that right up against that little orange line that I'm leaving there. Just a little bit of a white highlight on here. Let me get just a little more of that. Where is that creamsicle? Here it is. A little more of the creamsicle-y color. Needs a little more, just a bit more orange in it. We're just going to kind of play that a little bit right up here at the top. Giving it a little bit of a orange tone is what I'm trying to get. Just a small, I don't want it to be totally white. I want it to have a bit of an orange tone to this area. Okay. Come over here and do a little bit of that. Let's make it a little bit more orange. Not quite as creamy sickle. Just kind of coming down right around through here. And just a little bit of white to the bottom of it here. A little orange streak that goes right through here. Just gonna wipe that off. Give me a little white. Oh, I blended it away, didn't I? Let me get it again. Leave that little orange streak showing right there. Okay. Okay, I think that'll work, and then we'll do the rest of that in a moment. So we're gonna wipe, rinse this brush. I'm gonna get some brown. Let me see, where do I want this first tree to be coming from here? Down in here. It's gonna come right up out of here. We're just gonna get some brown and drag it up through here. Needed to give it a moment to dry, I do believe. Okay, little skinny tree just coming up out of the back here. It doesn't have to be straight. I'm not worried about it being straight. I'm worried about the paint adhering in the right places. But we're just going to start with a little tree back there, a little skinny little tree. Maybe I ought to use you, put you in the water. We're just going to come right up off of our little skinny tree and just give our little skinny tree a little skinny branch that'll just branch off right there, and we'll just give it another little skinny branch coming up through here. All right, this is going to be a darker tree, so I'm not going to do him yet. I'm going to just make this trunk a little wider down here. You got to remember, if the tree is going to be able to stand upright, it has to be wider at the bottom and slowly work its way up to being, well, maybe not slowly. Some trees are pretty short and stout and, you know, they don't have anything, you know, really growing out of them until they all of a sudden they just burst out into everywhere. And then other trees are long and skinny and they may not have any many branches at all. But this one's good. You got to make them at least wider at the bottom and then just kind of pull it up. Okay, and we're going to make another tree here next to him. Here, let's put it right here. A little wider at the bottom as well. I should be painting from the other side over instead of painting this side first. As you can see, I'm going to be having to hold my hand up over top of it. Odd little tree. Just kind of off in the background here. Sprouting some little branches. Just a couple of small trees right there. Then we're going to have one that, let's see, more or less kind of coming up out of this area, isn't it? We'll put him over here on this side. This one can be further back. I think I need to add a little water to that. That's kind of a thick, thick brown. Bit wider. Little branch just going off into nowhere. Ooh, he got that. All right, we'll just make it a little bit wider going down. He may be further back, but he just might be a bigger tree further back there, right? Who knows? There we go. We're going to leave him just like that. He's just a tree sitting further back. This one come right out of here. And he's gonna kind of lean in this direction. Sometimes it pays to follow your own advice and make things a little bit thicker as they're coming up out of there, huh? I mean, I gotta thin this down a little bit. There we go. That's better. Don't want it too thin, though. Another one that just comes right up out of here. I could actually go ahead and connect it because those trees are going to be much darker. Those trees that you see further back here. I'm just going to work that down into there. This one's going to come right up out of his back area. Not his back, actually, but you know. Behind him would be this little tree back here in the bushes. Back here in the woods. Yeah, come on, tree. Pull with me. And I'm not trying to make, I'm just trying to make some browner looking area back in here so that we've got some different look to our trees. Some of the trees are going to be a little bit darker up here in the front. I'll just pull that up that way. And we're going to make another one that's going to come out. Well, I don't want to get in that white yet. That's too wet still. We'll make one right here. Kind of coming up sideways. Every tree doesn't grow perfectly straight, right? Give him a long branch kind of coming off the edge here. That just kind of fizzles out. It's broken or, you know, just a bad limb, bad limb. bad limb. See, we'll put this one right back here, just kind of coming up through there like that. No, I think that's probably enough of the smaller trees in the background for now. We're going to work on the bigger trees at this point. I'm going to use this bigger brush. And I'm just going to start these with black. Coming right down here. That white's still a little wet, but that's all right. We're not going to worry about it. We're just going to work it. Come straight on up like this, and then he's going to have another branch that comes off right here. Give him a little U shape right there. Trying not to touch that. That a little bit thicker. Just little pieces going here and there. Okay, and then we're going to have another one of the larger trees right in behind him. Maybe I shouldn't. Well, yeah, it is going to be a larger tree. It is larger than those little skinny brown ones, that's for sure. Here, have a branch that comes out right there, okay, we're getting some of that to take shape a little bit back there now. Make him just a little bit bigger here. Okay. And we got this one right here. I know I need to get moving. This is going to take me forever to do this painting, isn't it? Okay. Let me turn this way a little bit so I can see my tree better. Am I still within your view? Yes, I am. Okay. More of that black. Pull the limb right out of here. Trying to smooth that just a little bit through there. Okay. One more big tree and we're done with the trees. Come on, paint. This is a pretty big tree. He comes all the way down here. Going to make some chunky snow down here, but for now, I'm just trying to smooth it all down. turn this back around. Take that right off of the edge. Just like that. Okay, and that's enough of the trees back there, I'd say. Surely. Certainly, huh? Okay, now I'm going to mix just a little bit of brown and black together to get me a darker brown, not quite so black. I'm just going to put that right in here. Right over here. Okay, I'm looking at it here, trying to see what I need to be doing at this spot. That goes right down around his back. I think that's all of this that I'm going to be using then, isn't it? Yeah, probably. Okay. Just a smidgen of blue. And that little squirt you heard is really about all I'm going to need of the blue. I'm just making a real light blue. Well, maybe not real light blue, but I'm making a light blue. Now I'm just going to take this blue and I'm just going to kind of go right along through here. Bring it down in here. My hair is tickling my nose. Like I'm gonna sneeze. Trying not to sneeze. You know how that is. Where your nose gets really itchy feeling. Okay, we're just getting some of that blue down in here. I'm gonna get some of that blue right in here. I'm gonna get some of that blue right along there. Back in here a little bit. White. Turn this. Bit of that blue right in here, don't I? Okay, I'm just going to keep adding more white into it here. I'm not too worried about where his tail is right there, because that's going to be all black, and we'll work on that in a minute. Not all black, but that part of the tail is going to be black at the end, so we'll worry about adding that into that in just a moment. Mixing that in right in here. Want a little bit of that dark blue to show through right there. Maybe just a little more. Okay, we can see the snow starting to come together a little bit here. this this way, where I can see just a little more. Just a little bit more. Get this back in here. This I'll probably have to come back and work on a few times, but for now I just want this to be real white right here. The whitest part. I don't want this to blend in right here. I'm just wanting this to kind of end up with that blue right down in there. This is just the shading of the snow. And then we can blend it in right down in here. I don't want to get too much of that white up in there. I want this to stay kind of dark in this area, but I also want it to... Okay. Let's see, I think this needs to be a little bit lighter right through here. Record it down a little bit. Okay, I think we've probably monkeyed around as much as we need to monkey around, and it's time to get... Oh, wait a minute, I forgot I wanted to play with the snow some. Give it a chunky look. I doubt that you can see it at all, but that's okay. I can see it. I know what it's doing here. Just a little bit across right through there. Okay. I think it's time to add the fox, right? Let me turn it this way. Get this brush right here. Turn it this way a little bit. Hopefully not get it all over the place. Go right into his eyes with a little bit of brown. Drop of water in this brown. It's awfully thick. It's been sitting here too long, I guess. Just a little bit of orange to that brown. Okay. Just put that right in here. His eye. Okay. Let me add a little bit of gold. Let me get this other little brush. Tiniest bit on the side right there. All right. Some black. Right underneath that eye. The top of that eye. Right. Let me go over here. Ooh, I went a little far up on that one. Okay, let me see what happened to this eye. I gotta tilt it up where I can look at it. Sorry, guys, but I gotta see it. Make this come right. I'm sorry, I'm gonna try to show you here what I'm doing, but just a second. That I got much too wide, but that's okay. I'm gonna work on that. I'm gonna go back over here and get a little bit of this gold. And drag it right down around the bottom of this is what I'm trying to do. Just okay, that'll work until I can get some white put in there. Come down here. Gotta move my hand up this way so I can get my hand on top. We're just gonna... work on his little nose here. Your Coco out there. That's working. Okay. His ears have black. There's deers in our backyard, and Coco does not like it. I can tell you that right now. That's what's going on out there. There's some deers out there, and she is not a fan. Or maybe she's a big fan. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe she's a super fan. Down here like that, and we're just gonna kind of bring it a little bit down and do here, put some black back in here. Inside of here. Across the top of this ear. almost like a black velvety kind of look to their ears. And that just kind of comes right in here and stops. That comes down here a little bit. We're just going to kind of fill in an area to hold for this dark in here because they've got a real dark inside their ears, some black. About like that for the moment. That's just a place to start here. And let's see, I need to mix a little bit of red and orange. Get me a darker looking, more of a reddish color. Get me more red. Not too red, though. Just a little bit darker color here, and we're going to put that right inside of here. Mix that in a little better. Here a little bit. Little out through here. Here. Under this eye. And we're just gonna get some of that back in here. Just for a little undertone in here. We need a little dark underneath. And of course, there's got to be a little bit in here. Because we're going to build this up. But we need a little dark back in here. Same with the back end right in here. A little more orange in here. to get it in his eye, Janet. Daggone it. Oh, I have to go over that spot again anyway. Oop, not that much orange. Have to work that out of there now. Now that really didn't hurt it any. Get a little redder looking up in here. Not too much up in there, because the ears are actually going to have white in them. But we'll get all that added in here in just a second. That a little bit. Got it on that eye. Well, I'm gonna have to fix the eyes, obviously, but we'll work on that in a second here. Hi, Gina. Thanks for joining me. I appreciate it. Okay, let me see. What am I getting to here? I'm getting into, let's see, I'm going to be needing some little bits of gold and little bits of yellow. Going to be added in here. So we're going to do a little bit of gold right here on the nose. Little snout area here. Add a little gold. Let me get a little more gold. Make it a little brighter. Excuse me. Add a little yellow to it. I'm going to add just a little bit of a yellow right in here under the eyes, and then I'm going to blend that with this little bit of orange. Lighten him up just a little bit in that spot. Get this here, and we're going to just Get a little water in it. Actually, that might help. Making just really quick little lines. Drag just a smidge of orange in there. A little more gold in here. Kind of just coming out over this way to where it's going to get into this whiter looking hair right in here. Add a little water. Seem to be adding a lot of water tonight. My paints are drying up on me. I'm taking too long to paint. Oh. Getting other paint and pink in my paint, in my white. You don't really want that. Kind of want this to... Working this around here. Okay, get a little more white. I'm sorry I'm holding it up. I can't really see what I'm doing with the lights in here, so I'm trying to hold it up a little higher so I can flick out some hairs. That's his leg right in there, so let me work on this right there. Get a little more white. We have to do still some more here to this, so I'm not going to stress over how that's looking at this very moment, but... let's come over here to this side. Let me see, it goes right through here, right? Actually, he's got this white on his side here, too. Give that a little more definition, won't we? I don't like that brush. That's not doing it. I need to get my fur brush out. This around here, you gotta get it down here under. Underneath this chin first. Okay. Work on this a little bit here. We got to give it some shading as well. It's going to have a little bit of black added to it here. That needs to be a little thicker right there. Okay. Get this up in here first, and then we'll worry about fanning it out in just a second. Right through here. Back that way. Let me look at this. It's got this pretty brown in it here too. So we gotta just kind of blend this in right here. And then let me get a little bit of orange here. Here's my little reddish browns. Put some of that right in there. And then we're gonna work this around. Got these little white hairs across the top of his head. Got a little bit of white going up around the ear. I don't think you guys can really see what I'm doing. I'm sorry. But I'm gonna fill this in with white real quick here, and then we're gonna flip it around, flick it around a little bit, and make it look hairy. I just gotta keep watering that down. I'm telling you, it's crazy. Put it in that way. Over here. Pull this around right in there. Okay, let me look. See what needs to be done here. This needs... little fine hairs. kind of brought out on the ear. It still looks a little odd, I know. Yeah. Bring this around this way. Let me get a little bit of this, a little bit of that. A little bit of this and a little bit of that and a little bit of this and a little bit of that. And we're just gonna keep working it and working it. Right through there. Let me see. Let me look at him. Hairs here and there. Just along his cheek a smidge. And then we're just gonna have to blend some in back here. All right. Just the littlest bit of white going around the edge of that. Okay, let me see. Where are we going to next? Where are we going to next? We got to darken this up. We got to work on his face. Excuse me. We've still got to get white. Right in here. That needs to come just up a little more. Yeah, not like that. Excuse me. I don't even know how long I've been up here now. It's probably hours. Let me just work on filling in his little chin. And that's just so I can keep an idea of where the shading is going to go. Okay, so now we need some of the darker color. And we're going to scrub that in right in here. Now come back and work on those little white places again. Give me some of the brown and some of the orange. A little bit of red. And let's get a little more dark in this one. Yep. Underneath here is going to be a darker color. Over here. Not there. Fix your mistake right away. It's all right. I just want to get some of this darker. Let me turn him a little bit. Make it a little bit easier. This is going to be even a little darker down in there, so we're just going to kind of work this. Start adding me some orange to it. Turn it around here a little more. What in the world is she doing now? She's just smearing away, aren't I? Yeah, I am. I'm gonna try to work that in to blend it. But yet still keep that darker down in here. Come on now, give me some water. Around here. Just gonna kind of fill this in and then we'll work on putting the lighter spots and so forth into it. Let me get a little more of this. Brownish color here. Okay, let's see. Just a little more orange right in here. Let me get this thinned down. Not better. That is better. Turn you around here a little bit. I'm just gonna make a couple of streaks with this white. Let me just see here, what can I do to fix this a little bit? Start adding a little bit of darkness to it. Oop, not with that junk hanging on it. Let's see, he's got this. He's got his leg right here. Front of this, and then just go right down underneath here. I'm just kind of looking here, trying to. Where I need to darken him up some. And I need to darken him up around the outside of his tail, I know that. Bringing this on down around the tail area. Giving that big fluffy tail. Might streak a little orange in there too, but we want a little bit of black blending in with those white hairs. that on there. Now, I'm going to turn it this way and pull it inward. Let me look at this. Making him a fluffy, fluffy tail. Few little black hairs running in through here as well. Working on that leg right there, trying to get that to look right. Okay, let's see. Little bit of darkness right along the bottom here. Don't want it to look too much like an outline. But now his tail's funky looking. I gotta work on that tail. This is a little funky right here too. Okay, so we're going to get some orange. here. Get me a little bit of this brown mix-up I've got going on. Just trying to bring that out there. It's kind of hard to see where the definition between his leg ends and his shoulders here, so. We're gonna bring this in here a little more. Maybe that's a little too much black around the outside of that tail. I'm not sure. Maybe we need to. Woof up this white here. Let's poof up his tail, huh? And now that looks a little more like a tail. That's still awfully bushy out here, though. Let me bring some more white out into it. Make a couple of them heading up in that direction. Looking a little more like a tail. Just some. A little shading in there. I think he needs a little more of a... Just a little bit of light right in here. I don't know, I could monkey with it for hours. I need to just get on with it, huh? Let's just do this right in here. Got a little bit of shading around his mouth right here. Couple of whiskers on the guy here. Darkness under his chin. Darkness right in there. Get my hand in the paint down here. Gotta watch what I'm doing. If anybody is still with me, let me say I so appreciate you. You can hang out this long with me doing this. I am impressed. I am certainly impressed with you. Oh, thanks, Gina. I appreciate that. Thank you. I'm working on him still. It's taken me forever. It's gonna come over this way. Give him a few extra there. And let's see, this needs to be kind of grayed up just a little bit. Not too much, but just a little bit right in here. Too much of that, though. I don't want too much of that to show. No. That's not what I want you to do. Go back and white you up. Just a little bit of an outlining here. Can't just have him over here with this white edge. Let's give him a little bit of gray right in here. Not too much. Just a wee bit. Just a wee bit of gray. Little bit up here. Just a little bit inside of his ears. You can kind of see the edge around his chin right here. Tried to give it a little bit of definition there on the side. Let's do just a little bit. Not like that. Daggone you, what are you doing? Working it under his chin just a little bit there. Make a few long hairs on this ear. A few long hairs there. Little bit inside of his ears. The white in that eye. I don't know if the one eye's got white enough. That might need to be a little whiter. Okay, guys. I think this thing's done. I mean, I could keep going and playing and painting and all of that, but honestly, I think I need to stop at this point. The more I keep messing and playing, the more likely I am to mess it up. And I kind of like how it looks right now. Well, thank you, Gene. I appreciate that. I'm just afraid to keep messing with it. Maybe I need to put a little gray right in the tail here. I can't ever just quit, you know? Just stop, Janet. No, I can't. I need to put a little gray in the tail. Just a little bit. Don't think you can even see what I did. I just gotta keep messing with it, guys. I'm gonna stop. I am going to stop. I am going to sign it and be done. It's time to just put an end to it, Janet. You can go on forever, or you can say, I think I got it. My paint is so thick right now, it doesn't want to do anything for me. Okay, That's even a sloppy JSS. I don't care. That's fine. That's how we're going to leave it, just like that. All right, guys, we're done with it. Thanks for being here. I appreciate you. Bye. Good night. Thank you.